Hey folks, it's Urban Rainbow, and we're outside the TY Expo, and we're Sarah Sunday. How you doing, Sarah?
Hey, how's it going?
And you got some buds to show us, don't you?
I do. I have buds right over here.
Holy cow.
All sorts of buds.
Wow. You're a girl that really likes her medicine, eh?
I do. I have to say I enjoy medicine and I enjoy strains. It's fun.
That's very apparent here.
It's a good time.
Where would you like to start the tour?
Let's start on this side, right over here.
Okay.
Let's start with the Horta Lab Sour Star.
Right.
This is, most of these are actually just seeds that I popped, and I've got various phenos of them.
Right.
This one, I only have one that I wanted to show you.
Mm-hmm.
It's got lots of crystals. Sour Star is a cross of Sour Diesel and Star Bud.
Right.
And it's a pretty nice hard nug. There are a few little issues with it, but we won't get into that.
Okay.
The next is by Humber Valley Seeds. It's Grape Kush, and it's my pheno number B, or letter B. It's really crystally, nice nugs, grapey smell, a little bit cushy, really beautiful effects. Out of all the seeds I popped this time, this was the only one that my boyfriend likes, so I guess it's, at least it's, at minimum, it's Josh approved.
Nice, that's important.
Yes.
What's this next one here?
Okay, this is another one of the Humber Valley Seeds Grape Kush, Pheno C, and again, nice snugs, nice producer, a little bit less dense, I'd say, than the other one, but not loose by any means, and good meds. Tasty, grapey, cushy, sounds good.
Daytime or nighttime?
I would say mid-afternoon.
Mid-afternoon?
I would say mid-afternoon. There's a little bit of a lift in it, too, and but the body's good.
So that's good for 420.
I mean, of course, I smoke Kush for breakfast, so you might... I don't know. My opinion on it might be.
Me too. I like Kush for breakfast.
So we don't fall asleep to Kush, but
no.
Other people, they might fall asleep to Kush. Maybe it's more like after dinner or something like that. But to me, it wasn't super heavy.
Mm-hmm.
It was good, bud. Okay, so the next one is Medical Seeds,
yep.
And I believe they're from Spain.
Right.
This is Prozac, and it's a cross of Soma Lavender and some type of Kush. I believe it's OG Kush. Lavender is, like, as you everyone probably knows, is my favorite medicine out there. Amazingly tasty, great muscle relaxing effects while not actually like putting you to sleep. Amazing medicine, and I find that it is amazing in any cross. It sort of lends to a lower flowering time and lots of crystals and an amazing flavor. Very sweet. So that everything is present in this Prozac that I described. Really nice nugs, super easy to grow, a little bit of love, and big buds, lots of trichomes, amazing smell and taste.
Wow.
I find it to taste a little bit, all the phenos taste a little bit different, but they
right.
taste kind of like a sort of a fermenting fruit or something like that, which is yummy in my opinion.
Cool.
So here's another one, Prozac B.
More of the same?
More of the same. I think this nug is, these ones are a little bit harder than the ones, the previous ones, but
right.
very similar, very lots of trichomes. I think this one has a little bit more than the other one. And another pheno of the same.
Prozac
again,
C.
they sort of have a very similar appearance, but a little bit different flavor and effects. I liked every single one of them.
Mm-hmm.
I would say that again is like a, to me, you could smoke it any time except for before bed.
Okay.
Works for me. Okay, now let's go. This is my bedtime strain. I call it go to bed immediately. Fall asleep, we.
Sounds exciting.
I have trouble falling asleep, so this is my favorite bud. Oh, let me get you a nug. Totally didn't set this up, and I apologize to the viewers out there.
No problem.
Okay, so
that looks
is,
like a nice nug.
Yes, it's very crystally and extremely dense. It's 8 weeks, and pretty much my favorite. It's Medman West Coast Sour Diesel. Now, everybody says to me, oh, Sour Diesel, and they immediately think East Coast Sour Diesel. This has absolutely nothing to do with East Coast Sour Diesel. Let me just make that plain immediately.
Okay.
It is like a crazy Afghanica, low to the floor, big stems, just, oh my God, what an amazing, this is prime, and prime weed, and it's got a crazy, like, cushy, skunky, fuely aroma. If I could happily just grow that, I'd be good. I might fall asleep constantly, so maybe that wouldn't be good. Okay, so I need one more strain. We'll figure out one more strain.
Okay.
So this is...
More research is needed.
Yes, more research is needed. Let's smoke. This is, again, the West Coast Serra Diesel again. This is just a more... This is like a couple months ago from my room, and this is more recent from my boyfriend's room.
Nice.
Yeah.
Does nice work.
Absolutely. So this is my own yummy strain, Hard Candy.
Right.
This is pretty much the densest nugs out of anything, and this is saying something. You cannot squeeze that. It's like, the only way to squeeze it is grinding it up.
Really?
Yes.
So you can break windows with those buds.
Pretty much. And we can make a knocking noise, maybe.
I actually hear them.
See? I'm just saying. And this has got lavender in it, which is, of course, my favorite. So
is that Soma's lavender?
Yes, Soma's lavender. It is the bomb meds out there. Best meds. Amazing muscle relaxing effects while having a little bit of a head and just the body effects without the tired grogginess that sometimes can accompany a heavy indica. So it's beautiful nugs, amazing muscle relaxing effects, helps my stomach out. I love Hard Candy. It produces, the only issue with it is that it doesn't veg very fast. So it's one of those ones that takes forever to get a plant that you can get a decent amount of clones off of.
Right.
Okay. On to the next.
SR-71.
So, Purple Kush. This is an all-time favorite of medical patients and just connoisseurs everywhere. Really tasty, grapey, cushy niceness. Hard nugs, lots of crystals. You could take it at the end of 7 weeks happily, probably, and everything would be good. I think this was 8. What more can you say?
It's a classic.
It's a classic.
It's kick-ass.
It's kick-ass.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Okay.
Okay, it's the last one.
Yes, this is, again, one of my own. This is Lilac Kush.
Wow. You know what? This is the frostiest of all the samples.
Yes,
this is the best for last, isn't it?
Yes, I saved the best for last. Thank you. Lilac is awesome. It's got... I can't even describe what it smells like. It's got the most unique smell. Every time I open up the bag for people, they're like, what is that? I don't know what that is, but it smells really good. So it's crazy in terms of flavor and taste. You can take it at 42 days. If you leave it for till like about 49, it'll go completely purple. Looks incredibly beautiful when it starts to go purple. It gets like lime green in stems and lime green in the veins with the purple. It's just like, wow. Really pretty plant. Tons of trichomes and just the smell takes over the whole grow room. It's just wild. And fast flowering.
Well, that's cool.
That's what we like.
Well, so, that's an awesome collection of buds here.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for allowing me to show you my buds.
Thanks for showing us.
Yes.
Now we're going to try each and every one, right?
Yes, let's start.
Okay, that's another video. In the meantime, keep watching Urban Ramo for more coverage of the TY Expo.
Thank you.